Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. Today I will show you how to get access to the SQL connection used by your Hibernate session. But before we start, please subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified about new Hibernate tip videos. I upload a new one every week. And here's today's question. We are using Hibernate in our application, and we now need to implement a reporting use case for which I want to use plain JDBC. How can I get the connection that's currently used by Hibernate? Hibernate doesn't provide any method to retrieve the Java SQL connection that's used by the current session. But you can call the doWork or doReturningWork method on the session interface to perform JDBC-related work. If you use Hibernate via the JPA API, you first need to unwrap your entity manager to get a Hibernate session. I explained it in more details in a previous video that I will link below. Okay, let's take a closer look at the doWork and doReturningWork methods. If you want to process some data without returning any values to the caller, you should call the doWork method with an implementation of the work interface. You can see an example of it here. The interface only defines the execute method. Hibernate calls it with a parameter of type Java SQL connection. This is the connection that's used by the current Hibernate session. And you can use it within the execute method to perform your JDBC operations. For all operations that return a value, you need to use the doReturningWork method and call it with an implementation of the returning work interface. As you can see here, you can do that in basically the same way as you call the doWork method. The only difference is that the execute and the doReturningWork method return a value instead of void. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!